think I know what you mean. There's an undeniable rapport, and yet we haven't made time for each other. Time alone. Easily remedied, if you like. I know a place. Not just yet. Let's choose our moment. Some quiet night, when the others are asleep and there's no distractions. I'll come for you. If you're sure. Fine. I'll be here whenever you rediscover your taste in company.
Nothing like a little camp drama to spice up the evening. It's almost a pity things ended so amicably. Seeing those two duke it out would be fun. Who knows? Drow? Mind flayers? Death? Hopefully not ours. But maybe answers, if we can convince the right people to talk. Darling, I'm hurt. I thought we had something special. I guess I'll spend my evenings lounging here while you do all the hard work. It sounds awful.
The Blade of Frontiers at your calling. That's the spirit.
Gladwill saw sense. Even more glad he decided to stick around. Takes a pretty slick mover to track down old Karlak. Fair. But still, the man's got a reputation for being lethal with that blade. I'm glad it's on our side. Copper for your thoughts. Aces.
Good thing for Will that Karlak called a truce. A tiefling that mighty would shred him to pieces and burn the remains. Now, what did you need? I expect I am your first. I suppose I am as alien to you as you are to me. I know of your kind, but I do not often encounter them. That large, fleshy nose of yours looks like a mistake. It was an observation, not a compliment. No matter. I do not intend to stay long in this place. I understand much beyond your comprehension. More to the point, I know the cure for our condition. It is imperative we locate a creche. You do well to observe more and question less. Yes, in great detail. It starts with a fever and memory loss. Then you start to hallucinate. Your hair falls out, and you bleed from every orifice. Your bones will change form. Your jaw will split to allow room for four great tentacles. All skin will turn to gore and be shed to reveal new flesh underneath. Then you have ceased to exist, and a mind flayer is born. Because I do not intend to let this happen. Not to me, and if you stick with me, not to you. We must find my kind and be rid of the parasite. It's as simple as that. The first symptoms should have long since started, though. That is what puzzles me. Yes, if you give it no further thought. But anomalies lead to surprises. Bad surprises. Besides, what hasn't happened may yet come to pass.
Brings to mind a story. The Devil with the Silver Tongue. An old fairy tale my father read to me. The kind with a hero, a villain, and a moral. A farmer made a deal with the devil, so the story goes. In exchange for the farmer's dearest fruit, the devil granted him a bottomless coin purse. The farmer's dearest fruit, naturally, was no apple nor peach, but his beloved daughter. We can learn a lot from fairy tales.
don't you think?
Refuse him, no matter how tempting the offer, no matter how delicious the feast he lays out for you. The cost will be too great. That's because you still have hope. But when he becomes your last hope, remember this. He'll require of you only what you're least ready to part with, and then require more still. You might think you'd give up anything for a cure. But the devil won't take just anything. He'll take everything. A most vicious one, in fact. It's made from pure bloodstone, carved from the Galena Mountains just north of the Moonsea. A reminder that sometimes blood must be shed and sacrifices must be made. But that story is reserved for lifetime friends and calmer days. By all means. My father once said, "One does not pursue a champion's life. One merely answers its call." So it was for me. I was hunting near the Cloakwood when I heard it. A child crying out from a lone farmstead. I found him in the fields flanked by goblins. His mother's corpse bled into the soil next to him. I don't remember much of the battle, but I remember drying the boy's tears after. Monsters preying on innocence, angry at the so-called good gods for tolerating the cruelty of the evil, angry at myself that it took so long for me to see the coast suffering. The frontiers demanded a blade, and so I heeded. And it's nice to meet someone of your talents. Having a worm wriggling in my skull didn't instill much confidence in the days ahead. With you as my ally, the future looks a little less daunting.
What's up for discussion?
The ringleaders have to die. The very natural order of things is in danger, thanks to them. Very well. My claws are yours.
Seems simple enough.
Defender of the people.
Hey, good looking.
I've got a long road ahead. Let's have a look.
cool.
Fearless. can't even catch my breath. take you through.
On the victor's path.
Strange power resonates within the corpse. It calls to you. Your limbs move of their own accord. There's something of value here, something your mind craves. Why let its host's memories go to waste? The tadpole has absorbed it all. Its experience could nourish you, strengthen you. Muscles loosen. The tadpole breaks free of its deceased host. Your mind is your own again. For now.
Hiding here. Ah, I'll give it a shot.
Look at this. I'm quite saved. A joy to see a familiar face in such a precarious setting. I guarantee the story of your daring rescue of my person will live on for eons. I intend to do just that. A trusty invisibility potion goes a long way in a place like this. We mustn't tarry, but I'd hate for our friendship to end here.
Please, won't you meet me once we've both slipped the goblin yoke? Smashing! Soon, my friend. Soon we can share the flagon of something liquid and a tale of derring do. I'll slip away when the coast is clear. See you soon, my friend. I simply can't wait to pick your brain!
Is drawing the wrong kind of attention. Keep going, and there might be trouble.
Greetings, child. I've met few aside from goblins here. Ah, are you also here to assist with the prisoner? I was invited to teach them some of my techniques. I live for pain and its intricacies, you see. But alas, these goblins seem to thrive on the crude and primitive. Pain without purpose is a terrible thing. Wouldn't you agree? Yes, one who claims to be a master of pain. Pain is intimate and loving, but trying to discuss that with these creatures. Forgive me, but that look in your eyes, something terrible has happened to you. Because I see those same eyes when I look in the mirror. Dear one, we've all suffered in these dark times. It is little wonder you bear scars of pain and anguish. Please, let me alleviate this pain. As the Maiden of Pain, the goddess Loviatar teaches us. Through penance, administered by my skilled hand. My work can grant peace and serenity, the likes of which few experience, it will be worth it. I promise.
I wouldn't let his skilled hand anywhere near me.
Oh, I have something exquisite in mind. Both Loviatar and I are interested in how you handle pain, dear one. And should you delight her, you will most assuredly receive her most gracious blessing. Trust me. Simply face the wall, and we can begin. Come now, dear child. It is time to repent. Simply face the wall and stay absolutely still. Yes, this will do nicely. The pain you suffer will cleanse you. Do not fight it. Do not keep quiet, dear one. Let me hear you. Keep quiet, dear child. Embrace it. Keep quiet, dear one. Let me hear you. Sweet child, while I enjoyed that, I'm afraid your reaction was lacking. To gain Loviatar's favor, every single strike must be met with an honest cry of pain, or perhaps a touch of begging. Nevertheless, thank you, and I pray you've learned from today's little lesson.
Your world has strange customs.
Don't group me with the likes of them.
True. You wouldn't have the grit.
And these things have stayed interesting.
Try this technique, or perhaps
blood. No, never mind. What path lies before me?
The lock clicks and opens.
Thank you. I better go before they catch us. I should be able to make it to the grove on my own. They need to know they're in danger.
Yes. It should be here somewhere. They said there was a hidden passage underneath this temple. The place was supposed to be abandoned, but when we arrived, Brian had instructions, but the goblins got him. They said they'd eat him. I have to go. I have to get out of here. I don't know. The boss didn't say.
He just said some wizard called Laroakan would reward us if we found it. That's all.
Almost got past. Aye. Might be we'll pay him a visit in return. That'll be some real fun.
On the move.
cutting to the chase.
It's hot in here.
Today, you four.
Mate.
fall by my hand. My luck.